Hello, welcome to Nakti by Kali J.N.S. And today is the commencement of the Black American series. And the Black American series is a video collation documenting the history of the Black American for the last 600 years. It is also philosophical and historical. So this series addresses what is a Black American? What has the Black American done? What is the Black American like? It's going to concretize the culture of the Black American, the tenets and principles. And it's also going to document the various significant points in history for this group. So the first video in the Black American series is titled, What is a Black American? And that is very important to address off rip because of we are very much having existential questions about our identity and what that means. And we're concretizing and codifying our culture and ethnicity because we have been a distinct, unique group for the last 600 years and even before that point. So Black Americans are an ethnic group based on a unique lineage in America. This group was involuntarily brought to North American landmass in 1429, 1451, 1526, and 1619. So this group was brought over to America when there was not any America. It was a wilderness. It was not even a country yet. And this was obviously during the transatlantic slave trade. So this group built the United States from ground zero because, again, they were brought over as free labor. And they obviously came to wilderness there when they got over to North America, which is our ancestors. So Black Americans' moniker, as far as what they name themselves, has changed throughout history, evolving from Negro, African American, Black, and Black American. The Black American is proud of their African ancestry, but they are not Africans. So that's why you see a lot of rift now with the Black American not really liking to be called African American, because for one, it doesn't speak to our unique lineage, and two, a lot of us have been on this landmass prior to the transatlantic slave trade. It is true, and this is a lot of cover-up, but it is true that there were Black natives already over here. It is also true that there were Black natives occupying the Caribbeans, all of the Caribbeans. Like, just like you have Fiji and you have Melanesia, you know, those are Black people over there that's been over there for the last 10,000 years. It was the same thing, believe it or not, in Jamaica. In Trinidad, in all of those land masses, and of course the landmass that is now called Haiti. So they were brought over here as well from over those landmass. So the Black American definitely acknowledges his and her African ancestry, because all you need to do is study the haplogroups and you can obviously tell that the haplogroup that is the average African American is found in West Africa. However, those haplogroups are 40,000 years old. So obviously, within 40,000 years, people will move around with the same haplogroup as the Sub-Saharan Africa and East Africa. So again, the Black American is proud to have African ancestry, but they are not African. So most recently, Black Americans are concretizing their ethnicity based on lineage to prevent confusion with Black immigrants who voluntarily come to America and have zero ties to the Black American lineage, experience, and culture. The need to separate from the African American moniker stemmed from the great influx of people from Africa and the Caribbean since 1965. This immigration eroded what it meant to be African American because it erased the lineage of Black Americans who had been in this country for 600 to 1,000 years. So after the Voting Rights Act, Congress passed new immigration laws replacing the Johnson-Reed Act of 1924, which had favored the admission of Northern Europeans with the Immigration and Nationality Act. The new law scraped the rule of national origins and enshrined a first-come, first-served principle that made allowances for the recruitment of needed skills and the unification of divided families. Before 1965, Black people of foreign birth residing in the United States was not visible. This is just a fact. And again, if you were to ask these groups of immigrants, would you come to America in the 1870s? Would you have came to America in the 1920s? They will most likely say no, because for one, there was slavery at that point. And two, there was Jim Crow and Reconstruction Black codes at that point. So when they say Black Americans never contributed to making it a better place for Black immigrants to come over here, it's simply not true. Just ask them, would you have brought your ass over here in 1776? Would you have came voluntarily like you did now? And they would say no. So again, this is very important to know, because according to the 1960 census, their percentage of the population was to the right of the decimal point. That's how small the Caribbean and African population was. But after 1965, men and women of African descent entered the United States in ever-increasing numbers. During the 1990s, 900,000 Black immigrants came from the Caribbean and 400,000 came from Africa. Still, others, you know, came from Europe and the Pacific Rim. So in the beginning, there was little confusion as to who was African American, because Black immigrants were adamant about declaring themselves based on their nationality. For instance, Jamaican Americans or Nigerian Americans gladly stated they were not Black, or told Native Black Americans to their face that they were not African American, based on the fact that most of them had never been to Africa. And to be honest, that's a fair point. You know, so a lot of us grew up thinking that we were African American, and when we would go and try to connect, we were told we were not Africans. They can clearly tell, just on an ancestral and metaphysical level, that we are not African. So they were correct in saying that, and also they were correct in addressing using their nationality first, as far as Jamaican American and Congolese American, etc., etc. However, Black immigrants would often take on the identity of Black Americans to take advantage of programs and benefits that were solely for Black Americans who have a 600-year lineage in America due to the injustices that we have faced. So Black Americans were exhausted at the disrespect and confusion of these arrivals and opted to concretize their culture and identity under a Black American moniker. So it is very important, because these immigrants were coming over here and disrespecting us, and we wanted them over here as to basically have more numbers. Like, we felt, figured, oh, if there's more Black people, we can bridge the gap. We'll have Pan-Africanism. We'll get together and learn things about one another's culture. And it simply did not work that way. These people came over here and really went into straight competition mode with Black Americans while using their resources, exhausting their resources, disrespecting them, and call themselves looking down on them when they had to flee their own countries, when they couldn't build or do what they're doing now here in their own country. So the Black American said they're tired of being lumped all in as one group when we are not, and we're tired of other people disrespecting. The biggest reason for a lot of the concretizing of our own identity and lineage is because of the disrespect of foreign Blacks. Had that not been the case, we most likely would have probably just kept calling ourselves African Americans. Why not? Wasn't a big deal. And Black Americans are very giving and very accepting people, so nobody would have cared if they would use our programs had we really just been a genuine family. But a lot of these immigrants are backstabbers. They are very cutthroat and arrogant, and they will disrespect you when you can easily point to their own homelands and see how they're living, how their stuff is not developed. And so there's no reason for them to come over here with smugness. So it has to be called out, and it will be called out every time. So now the Black American says, we're all we got. We want our own identity. So the Black American ethnicity is splintered into tribes now, and clans, or a clan might be a better word, such as the Geechee, the Creole, Ados, FBA, OBA, Indigenous American, and Kofaume. All of these groups are Black American, meaning they have that lineage for 600 years, they are part, some of them are even part Native American. And those have, they have mixture with African DNA and European DNA. This is just a fact. And all of these groups, for various phenotypical, geographical, and even ideological differences, have decided to form their own groups. They're all valid. They're all lineages. They may have different philosophies, different politics, different essences of their culture. But these clans share the same lineage, and hence they are still Black Americans. And to be honest, this splintering is common in African ancestry. So for instance, someone from Ghana, their nationality is Ghana, you know, and it's millions of people in Ghana, but they have over 100 tribes, such as the Asante, Iwa, Fante, Dagomba, Akan, and more. So they have all those tribes, but they're still Ghanaian. It is the same thing for all 54 countries in Africa. Another example would be how you have Nigerians. There's 200 million of them, but they have various tribes and clans. They have the Yoruba tribe, the Hausa, the Fulani, the Igbo. So it's the same concept. This is something that is very much indigenous to the African experience. It is something that is in our DNA to do that. We'll just splinter off into groups, even though we're the same people. We will splinter based off of ideologies, phenotype, geographical locations. That has been the African way for 3.8 million years. I've been studying this because I couldn't understand, you know, why wouldn't you just call yourself one people, one group, at one time, all times? And that's just nothing that I cannot find that nowhere in African history. So when it comes to the Black American, them being of African ancestry to the tune of 60 to 70%, that DNA is still in them. So they still have that inclination to form groups and with their own tribe, with their own like-minded people. So there's nothing wrong with that. So all of the groups that I mentioned, do we have the splintered groups that are still a part of the Black American moniker, the Black American ethnicity? And remember, that is the same, all those groups, they have been here for 600, 700 years, and some even further, dating back to 5,000 years on this landmass because of their Native American bloodline, their African bloodline, and now within the last 500 years, they have had admixture from the European bloodline due to the raping of enslaved ancestors. So this video answers the question, what is a Black American? So now you know that we want to, and we are consciously separating ourselves from the Caribbean and Africa, acknowledging that we have African descent. We know that the Black American has a haplogroup of EM2 for the men, 60% of them. The EM2 haplogroup is the descendant of the EV38 haplogroup, which is found in the Horn of Africa, East Africa, and Sub-Saharan Africa. The EV838 haplogroup is also found in ancient Egypt. Ramesses the first, Ramesses the second, Ramesses the third. They come from an EV38 haplogroup. This gave birth to the EM2 haplogroup, which is currently found in all of West Africa. So 60% of the Black American has an EM2 haplogroup on the paternal lineage side. Also, 1 in 3 Black Americans have the Thuya gene. Queen Thuya was a queen in Egypt. So everyone is like, oh, you guys are trying to claim Egypt. We're studying the haplogroup of these ancient people. And for two, Egypt is a 15,000 year empire. So those people moved all around. That is why you can find the Sub-Saharan haplogroup in the pharaohs in Egypt. So they moved and they were conquered. And a lot of those Africans from West Africa were sold off into slavery and came to America. So the Black American is understanding their haplogroups, their DNA, their ancestry, and their lineage. And we want our own separate identity. We don't want to be lumped in with other groups of people that are being tethers or who are body snatching the Black American's essence and wanting and being really jealous of us, while at the same time disrespecting us. And we could feel this energy. We could feel this very negative energy coming from foreign blacks, for the most part. Now, the ones who are actually over still on the motherland continent, when we go over there, these people are very pleasant to us and very loving. And because they have a different spirit. But the ones that are voluntarily coming over to a racist country, they have one agenda, and that agenda is to assimilate and to get in on anything Western. So these people are, they're pretty much sending over brainwashed people, brainwashed immigrants for the most part. They're not conscious. Some are. So these people are cutthroat to the Black American. They feel like they have to stump over us to get ahead in this country. So that is why the Black American have been having such a problem with these other groups of people who have started a beef, a non-existent beef with us as a group for no reason, only because of this brainwashing that they have. So they're projecting a lot of things onto us. They are buying into a lot of stereotypes and things that are about us. And it's like, okay, if you want to do that, fine, but don't come around us and don't try to get in our resources. Don't try to be all in our culture. Stop singing our music. Stop making our music. Stop playing our roles in movies. Like, this stuff is just getting ridiculous. And we have tried to befriend, and we have tried to reach out. So it's not on the Black American. This has started with them. So never let anyone tell you that you are being divisive, Black American, by wanting your own group and separating yourselves, because you cannot name one thing that Africans and Caribbeans have done to benefit us as far as Pan-Africanism, but you can name a whole bunch the other way around, with the exception of Marcus Garvey and Stokely Carmichael, which that was 200 years ago, damn near 100 years ago. So we want our own group. We're going to look out for ourselves, and we're going to do for ourselves. And once these people can evolve in their consciousness to realize that they all they got, and they can study their own history and understand the Conference of Berlin and understand how Africa got divided and understand keenly how they got in this situation of colonialism and even having a diaspora, having the African diaspora. Once they can truly understand how all that comes into play, what does that mean, and what does that mean about the society that in which you want to integrate yourself in? Once they truly can break that down in the sense of they understand their own self within that system, basically they have an enlightened mind. They have a consciousness that is in keen and in tune with blackness and with being melanated. Then we'll be able to talk one day and be able to be a family again. But we cannot be a family with people who undermine us, and we cannot be a family with people who don't love themselves and don't honor themselves. And believe it or not, the Black American has higher self-esteem than a lot of these people in the diaspora, straight up. So does the Black American have beef with the African and the Caribbean? No, hell no. We just need time. We just want to go our own way. We just need some space, basically. We just need some space from y'all. Y'all figure it out. We've been in this country for 600 years, and we know everything about this system. It's ancestral. So we are watching y'all from the outside looking in, seeing y'all do the same shit we did 200 years ago, to be honest. And we're kind of just looking like, okay, they're not going to get anywhere with that. So eventually, when they wake up, we'll be here. But until y'all wake up, just keep going up that stream of consciousness. Now, again, to the Africans who have no idea what I'm talking about, and they have love in their heart, and they have never, ever disrespected my people, then we love you back. And we want your energy, we want your talents, we want your love, and we are going to give it back in return. So if you are not one of those Africans that are not what I just discussed, the people that have come over here, disrespected my tribe, and following the orders that they cannot interact with us, that they cannot critically think too much about the system. If you are not like that, then I am not talking about you. But the crux of the Black American series stems from this negative energy that my people is receiving from y'all. And of course, white people, we've always received negative energy. That's like a day in the park with them. We always get the evil eye from them. But when we see y'all starting stuff with us in our own land and pulling crap and trying to act like us, but then disrespect us, but acting like y'all Black American when y'all not Black American, So y'all said we wasn't African and that we can't be all in y'all stuff and y'all we never be African? Fine. We are Black Americans. We have our own lineage. We have our own culture. And we do have the same haplogroup, whether you want to admit that or not. We do have the same African haplogroup. So you can't take anybody's birthright. This is what this is all about. Wanting to take the Black Americans' birthright from them. Everybody, we know where we came from. And there was a landmass that we were particularly stolen from and sold off from. And I'm going to break that down. Because the Black Americans who are the descendants of the enslaved ancestors that got sold off, a lot of them, a lot of tribes in Africa don't want to tell you this, but they were selling off rival tribes that they were jealous of, tribes that they were backstabbing, niggas that they was backstabbing and jealous of. How you're not gonna sell, you know what I mean? You gonna sell people that you feel threatened by. You gonna help sell your people off that you don't like. So a lot of us over here, that's why we were able to do so much as a group of people. As Black Americans, we have accomplished so much, invented so much, and built so much, and know how to still do it, and can make so many different things, and can think in ways that has not ever been accomplished before. The reason why that is because they sold off niggas that they was jealous of. So that's a fact. So now, you had 500, 600 years later, we still the descendants of those people that they wanted to cut out, that they wanted their bloodline to disappear, that they wanted to bury. So now when we get involved with each other, they still have that envy and they still feel like, who do y'all think y'all are? And now they want to clown us and say y'all were the slaves, but then you go and look at Africa and they don't own them resources either. They don't get no benefit off of that. They have puppet leaders. None of them are running shit. They don't have no Wakanda-like actual country or no Zamunda country. So in all 54 countries, they still have this colonizer energy going on still. And they all did get colonized. So even if they're all saying, oh, well, y'all were enslaved. That could be true. But look at us now. And we still built the greatest country on this planet. So they understand that. And then there's like, we try to wipe y'all out. And now y'all over here getting all those as somewhat benefits of that Western imperialist regime that y'all sold us off to. And now they feel some type of way and feel like, well, I need to get a crumb for that system too. That unfortunately, we were forced to build. The Black American was forced to build it. So that envy, that's ancestral, that hatred, that vitriol, a lot of that is spiritual. And that can easily be broken down. So any fingers they want to point at us, point it right back and start talking about their infrastructures. Stop letting people bully you, Black American. Stop letting people call themselves looking down on you. These people have no right to look down on you when they septic tanks and when they infrastructure and they water supplies is looking the way it is in all of these countries. I've studied them. We all had that dream of being an African and honoring only our African side. But then we go and try to connect. Some of us actually moved over to Africa and seen clear as day. You're gonna see we're not the same. And there's nothing wrong with that. Because I still would like to move back. A lot of us still plan on going back, Black Americans, because we have no hatred in our heart towards our brothers and sisters. Zero. Zero hatred. But we got the smoke for whoever we with the shits for whoever want to pull that bullshit with us and pull that disrespect. You're going to get it right back. Right to your face. We just let you know that right now. And you're not about to claim our fucking identity anymore. We don't want you all acting like you a Black American, but you want to go and call us Akata behind our back and all this crazy shit. And no. And be all low-key jealous as hell. We not dealing with that no more. You're going to come correct and lift us up so that we can lift you up. So that is the reason why the Black American is creating their own identity. And that is the reason for this series, to be honest. To be honest, because I'm seeing our history get buried and bullshitted on. And I'm going to cover our history from 1451 to 2020. I'm not playing out here. 1451 to 2020, we're going to be doing the whole historical aspects of it. But this video is more of a philosophical, what is the Black American? It's a rhetorical, it's an ontological question. What is a Black American? Who is the Black American? Now you see, and we're also gonna do a video of what does the Black American look like? You wanna stay tuned for that, because we're gonna be comparing our faith features to our brothers and sisters so we can learn how to identify each other. Not to say, oh, our features are so this and others. No comparison of better, you know, no hierarchy of who looks like, we ain't pulling that. But I'm gonna show you the picture of the Black American, how Black Americans look, including our Geechee and Creole tribes. I'm gonna show you them. We're gonna show you with, compare you with the Caribbean, the Haitian. So you can know that we don't look the same, the Jamaican. And everyone is beautiful. No one is, you know, better than the other. But we're not gonna be, now we'll be able to identify when someone is a Haitian, when someone is a Senegalese. Senegalese people are very beautiful. They're very dark skinned. We're gonna show them. We're gonna show all the mixed, all the looks of how a Eastern African looks, how a Western African looks. Oh, we not playing. How a South African looks. And then this is the Black American. And we gonna be looking side by side. And of course, the Afro-Latino. We gonna be looking, and y'all gonna know how to recognize your each other, Black American. We need to be able to recognize each other. So then when other people is talking, acting like they Black American, we know, we can instantly know something is up. Because we do have a look. We have a very specific look now. And yes, some of us are lighter and darker, but there's still a look, straight up. There's still a Black American look, because our mixture is very specific. African, Native American, and British European. So we know how the hell that mixture look. So we're gonna start studying the phenotypes of each other. We getting serious here. We getting deep, because for one, the goal of the Black American is to evolve its consciousness, to evolve her and his consciousness, so they can become free mentally. It's not so much the slavery is mental now. So the Black American is on a journey to free the mental slavery and to develop a culture, to develop that. Other people are not concerned with freeing the mental slavery. They're just not. So we're having problems where there's people literally trying to stop us from progressing, and they look just like us. And then when we figure out their background, oh, they're from the Caribbean or they're from Africa. And they have that mental slavery and that dependence. They have that codependence, where we want independence from that system. They have a codependence on it. So it's like they feel like, let's bury them because they're going to mess it up for the rest of us. So we peep game. And if this is not you, just know I'm definitely not talking to you as an African or a Caribbean, that if you don't have that mindset. And I definitely don't mean no disrespect, because I don't have any malice in my heart for Black people, period. But this disrespect has gotten so disgusting in my eyes. I have literally been disgusted with y'all behavior. And it just has to be called out. It's as simple as that. And the Black American must do something about it. We need space to develop more self-love for ourselves and to figure out more strategies. We can't have y'all in our mix, because y'all messing stuff up, and y'all fucking up the energy. Y'all really are. And that doesn't mean that we will not date. That doesn't mean that we cannot hang out. Again, we are open-minded people. The Black American woman, she likes the way the African man looks, so she's marrying him in droves. Yeah, okay, whatever. But still, she must recognize, and he, the Black American man, we are our own group, and we do have a separate lineage. That doesn't mean we're going to disrespect other groups like y'all have done us. We don't need to project our insecurities onto other Black tribes and other Black groups. We just want our respect. So this is the first video of the Black American series. The next one is the history. We're going to cover 1441 to 1870. And then we're breaking down then after that, we're going to cover Reconstruction. It's going to be deep. So stay tuned. And yes, this is not the typical docu-series, because I'm more edgy. So I say I'm a straight shooter. I'm not politically correct. So this is not going to be like a PBS type shit. I wanted to do it that way, but that's just fake to me. Because I have to call out I have to detail the passion and the reasons of why I felt this was so serious. And detail the reasons why I feel the Black American deserves their own ethnic lineage. So stay tuned for more hot fire. I love y'all, and I'm going to talk to y'all later. Peace.